anybody?
Yay! I like it.
Very good.
I'm completing it. Impossible! Impossible! Is this one?
Let's count.
20, 30, 40, 41, 50, 41, 45, 46.
And the answer is?
46.
Cool.
Just about more.
You guys did a great job.
It looks weird, similar to Tetris.
That was a wonderful job.
What did we
got
to do with these?
Who were you able to get?
Did two problems.
How many left over?
Six. I'm already on the last answer.
Oh, well, so now, hey, what could those six kids do to have some fun?
So I'm going to hand back your little books. You can start thinking about your problem.
What are you drawing? What's that?
Mr. Brown,
do you want these to put them all in their little books, or how do you want to do that?
And then you have some place to keep them, or?
And along these layers, there's these different organelles. And that's what you have to take some of that scrap paper you have and cut out some of the organelles. Like this protein sac here, or this vacuole right here. You've got to be able to cut those out and put those in to show kind of a 3D effect is what I'm after. And also, to teach you that not all these organelles are just located in one place in the cell. A lot of people think these are down here by the nucleus, and they're not. They're scattered throughout the cell, within the cell membrane, and that's why the cell membrane has layers.
That's an honest answer.
He does this first.
This first, and then this.
What DNA looks like, not at the molecular level, but at least what a... Hey, guys!
How would you draw it on a blank piece of paper?
All right, how about if we put three together? How about you three? You'd like to work together? And you all have a game board like this. Mm-hmm. And watch what's going to happen. We're going to demonstrate right here. What's your name? Steven. Steven's going to take his dice, and he's going to roll his dice. Watch. He rolled a, it fell down, and he rolled a four. So if he looks at his sheet, what word goes with four?
When.
So Steven is going to ask a when question about the story to the people in his group. Can you think of a when question? Okay, ask him a when question. He's gonna read quickly again.
Well, I just thought I'd find pictures that fit the description of the words that I was looking at. I'm Native American, and this is a predominantly Native American school, so all of the things that we do a prayer in the morning. And place, just, I don't know, it can mean a lot of different things. And I don't know, to me, it just really matters where you're at some point. Like, especially now, I'm at school, and this really determines on where my life is going to go right now.
Mm-hmm.
Regarding place.
And is it place where your head is at, where your heart is at, or where your body is at?
I think a little bit of both, in all honesty. And mind. If your mind's not in the same place you are, then you can't really do much. 21st century skills, that's probably one of the most important parts of this slideshow. Because, well, if you don't have 21st century skills, then it's hard to really do anything in this modern world, because you got to learn how to interact with people and know the way people talk and what it means and how to have an open mind, but yet still kind of go into a little box so that you don't get too out of control. And the visual-spatial instruction, people may like start off slow, but then they could just like pass you up because you think that, I got this. Maybe some people might need a little bit more instruction on how to do a project, but that just means that they're more interested in it, and they want to know exactly how to get it right.
That's a great.
And self-confidence, this is very, very, very important than just...
All right. If you go with me in order, we have a little bit of a bio here on a very famous person, Vincent van Gogh.
These are all Van Gogh's paintings. And every word of the song is expressed by what you're seeing.
Hi,
just spend a few moments and tell Mr. Lassos about why you felt the way you did as you were drawing what you were drawing.
I drew this because it showed that the flower is very sad. And then here are the raindrops. I don't know, rain just kind of gives me a sad feeling, but then I like it. And then I'm feeling kind of down today, because I got my phone taken away in art class, and also because me and my friends are arguing again. So I'm
And write down as many different things about the way the music and Vincent van Gogh's art made you feel.
The ragged men in ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
Yes, sir.
Powwow.
Cool. This is one of my favorite parts. What's this?
Food.
Well, we're going to talk not just about the activity, but we want to put you into that picture. We want to make sure that you're in the picture. We've got 150 colors. All right? Because we're not going to do stuff in black and white.
No.
How many of you dream in color? That's kind of what this is about. I'd like you to write down as many ing words as you can think of. Would you write as many ing words as you can think of? And if you need some help with the spelling of some of the words, raise a hand. We'll come around and help you. Sentences with as many of those ing words as you can. You don't have to use them all. Some of you have like 30 words. It's going to be really hard. But use those and string them together in sentences.
Tell us the story that you were trying to draw.
Flying and dimensionality, that's where we're going to go. So.
Nice!
See, it flies a little bit better with that, yeah?
I forgot how you do the second step, or the third step.
Well, it depends. I don't know what you're going to make.
Like the first video that we saw. Like how we,
Sure you can.
2, 1, go! Nice!
Did you see mine?
Nice!
I love the same like that!
Nice!
And an ing.
Swirling.
Nice!
Spinning.
Yes.
Soaring.
I like it.
Flying.
Very nice.
When you have to write, there's a translation going on. It's like going from Spanish to English. It's hard to do. You're searching, and so it makes you look slow, but you're not slow. We're doing translation. We started with a vision, right? We saw the vision of flying. Then we translated that into the airplanes, the design engineering. Then we translated it into the artistic. Then we flipped it over and we translated it into words. It's verbalizing. The key for visual-spatial learners is translation from vision to creativity, design, engineering, production, testing, art, using ing words, and only then writing. Some of these kids had previously been totally blocked at writing and then produced their first 100-word essay or even poetry.
In the summer of 2010.
Maybe you could draw a picture of how you feel, you draw a picture of what you think of when you think of an Indian mascot, you draw pictures that came to your mind when you were reading this article,
I brought materials. And you can have as many of these as you want. But my suggestion is that you draw something. It can be cartooning, or if cartooning isn't your thing, draw. And you don't have to draw anything that looks like anything. It can be abstract. I have, all these colored markers to work with, and I brought along charcoals.
You want some Sharpies too?
Yeah. Oh yeah, good, good. Excellent.
Think about that article and think about the images that come in your head, like Steve said. They don't. It doesn't have to be a picture of anything. It can be something abstract.
Wow. Look, wow. Look at that. No wonder she didn't want to share. I mean, look at that. Wow.